Hello everyone, welcome to GradeUp. My name is Vikas Bhadoria and I welcome you back on the video tutorial on heat transfer. In my previous video lecture on heat transfer, we have studied heat exchangers and its type, classification of heat exchanger. Also, we have studied design methodology of heat exchanger by LMTD and NTU method. In today's video, we are going to apply those concepts of heat exchanger to solve some previous air gate questions on the topic of heat exchanger. And as I have told you, that this topic heat exchanger is very important because every year at least one question comes from this topic of heat exchanger. Alright. Now before that, I want to tell a very important information that we at GradeUp has provided you free online video course for mechanical engineering that is recorded by gate toppers and experienced faculties. This free video course consists of study plan for 90 days, which contains 200 plus video lectures, 250 plus quizzes for all the topics, for all the subjects, and followed by live doubt session on some quizzes or some questions which are there in the free video course. We'll be organizing live doubt session to resolve your doubts. So you can follow all these things by going on the link which is given in the description below for the free online gate mechanical engineering course. Okay, so the link for that is given in the description below of this video. You can follow that link and you can start practicing for gate 2019 by going through our free video course for mechanical engineering that contains the complete syllabus of gate 2019, and those video lectures, as I have told you, are recorded by gate toppers and experienced faculties. All right, so you can just go through the link given in the description below and follow our free video course. Now in today's session, we are going to solve some previous questions based on heat exchanger. And so the first question is from gate 2014 set 2. In this question, it is given that in a concentric counterflow heat exchanger, water flows from the inner tube at 25 degrees Celsius and leaves at 42 degrees Celsius. The engine oil enters at 100 degrees Celsius and flows in the annular flow passage. The exit temperature of the engine oil is 50. Mass weight of the water and the oil are 1.5 and 1 kg per second. The specific heat of water and oil are also given to you. You have to determine the effectiveness of the heat exchanger. Alright. So as I have told you in the video lecture of heat exchanger, that whenever questions from heat exchanger comes, you have to firstly draw the diagram. So as mentioned here, it is a counter flow heat exchanger. So you have to draw the temperature profile for this. Alright. Now you have to see what are the inlet and exit temperature of hot fluid and cold fluid. Okay, so cold fluid will enter from here and hot fluid will enter from this side as it is a counter flow heat exchanger. Now, what is the temperature of hot fluid? As it is given that water flows through the inner tube at 25 and leaves at 42. So, it's quite obvious that water is a cold fluid because its temperature is rising. Okay, so inlet fluid is water, cold fluid is water. And the outlet temperature of the water is given to you 42 degrees Celsius. What is a hot fluid? Hot fluid in this case will be oil. And the inlet temperature of the oil is 100 degrees Celsius. And the outlet temperature is, hot fluid is equal to 50 degrees Celsius. Alright. Now also what is given to you? Mass weight of hot fluid is given, which is 1 kg per second. And mass weight of cold fluid, which is water, is also given, which is 1.5 kg per second. Alright. So, what you need to find? You need to find effectiveness of heat exchanger. Also, what is given to you? Specific heat of the hot fluid is equal to 2130 joule per kg Kelvin, and specific heat of cold fluid is equal to 4178 joule per kg Kelvin. Alright. Now, to find the effectiveness of heat exchanger, as I have told you, the formula for effectiveness is equal to actual heat transfer over maximum possible heat transfer. Now this actual heat transfer can be either MSCPH into THI minus THE, or it can be equal to MCCPC TCE minus TCI, provided that what is the value of Q maximum. And Q maximum, as you know, it is equal to MCP minimum THI minus TCI. Alright. So, MCP minimum means the product of mass and specific heat of hot fluid and cold fluid, whichever value is minimum, you have to enter that value. Okay, so we have to firstly multiply this. So, MHCPH will be equal to 2130 into 1, which will be equal to 2130. And MCCPC will be equal to 4178, that is the specific heat of cold fluid, that is water, into 1.5. And that will come out to be 6267. Alright. Now you can see that out of MSCPH and MCCPC, MSCPH is lesser than MCCPC. Alright. So the smaller value will be MHCPH. So you have to put here MSCPH. And as I have told you that whichever value will be put over here for specific heat, that value will be here in the actual heat transfer. So actual heat transfer will be equal to THI minus THE. Alright. And the maximum heat transfer will be equal to MSCPH into THI minus TCI. Okay. So after putting these values, MSCPH will get cancelled out. Okay. THI minus THE will be equal to 100 minus 50 divided by THI, that is inlet hot temperature fluid minus inlet cold temperature fluid, which is equal to 25. So after solving it, the value will come out to be 0.666. Okay, so the answer will be equal to 0.66. Alright, so the effectiveness of heat exchanger is 0.66.
Subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to never miss any update from CREATOC.
Next question again from 2014 set 3. In this question, it is given that a double pipe counterflow heat exchanger transfers heat between two water streams. Alright, so it is given the question, it is a counterflow heat exchanger, and the two fluids that are flowing in the counterflow heat exchanger are both water. Alright. Tube side water is at 19 liter per second. The mass weight of tube side water is 19 liter per second. Is heated from 10 degree Celsius to 38 degree Celsius. So it is given the question that tube side water is getting heated up. That means in the tube, cold water is flowing. Shell side water is at 25 liter per second, is entering at 46 degree Celsius. Assume constant properties of water. Density is given and specific heat is also given. So constant properties of water means that MH and MC are given to you. Okay, that is mass weight of cold fluid is equal to 19 liter per second. So it will be equal to 0.019 meter cube per second. And hot fluid is equal to 25 liter per second. So this will be equal to 0.025 meter cube per second. I hope you know the conversion, that 1 liter is equal to 1 by 1000 meter cube per second. Alright. Now next thing is that you have to draw the temperature profile for this counterflow heat exchanger. So what you need to find here? The LMTD for this counterflow heat exchanger. Okay. So you can find the LMTD by, firstly you have to draw the temperature profile. So for temperature profile, you know that the cold fluid is entering at 10 degrees Celsius. Alright, and the exit temperature of cold fluid is 38 degrees Celsius. Alright, and the hot fluid is entering at 46 degrees Celsius. Okay, now you have to find the exit temperature of hot fluid, that is not given to you. How you can find that? You can find that by applying energy balance equation. So energy balance equation will be equal to MHCPH. As I have told you, for LMTD method, by design by LMTD method, to find the, we will be knowing three known temperatures, and the fourth temperature is need to be found out. That can be found by energy balance equation. Okay. So this, applying this energy balance equation, this value will be same because the flowing fluid is water. Okay. And for water, this specific heat value will be same, but for hot fluid, this is given to you 0.025 mass weight of hot fluid into THI, which is 46 minus THE, you need to find out. And this is given to you 0.019 into TCE minus 38 minus 10, that is 28. Okay. So after solving it, outlet temperature of the hot fluid will come out to be 24.72 degrees Celsius. Okay. So I hope the same value is coming. For if you are solving this question, so THE will be equal to 24.72. So if you put this value here, 24.72, Next thing is that you have for finding LMTD, you need to find this delta TI and delta TE. Okay, that is difference in inlet temperature and difference in outlet temperature. Okay, so this will be 46 minus 30, that is 8 degrees Celsius, and this will be equal to 14.72. Okay, so LMTD will be equal to delta TI minus delta TE over log of delta TI over delta TE. Okay, so after solving it, the value of LMTD will come out to be, you have to just put these values here, okay, and the value will come out to be 11.03 degrees Celsius. Okay, so the value of LMTD will be equal to 11.03 degrees Celsius. So I hope you are getting the same value. Now, next question again from GATE 2015, set 2. In this question, it is given that a balanced counter flow heat exchanger has a surface area of 20 meters square and overall heat transfer coefficient of 20 watt per meter square Kelvin. And the flowing fluid is air. Air is having specific heat of 1000 joule per kg Kelvin, is entering at 0.4 kg per second and 280 Kelvin. Okay, so the inlet temperature of the air is 280 Kelvin, it is entering, is to be preheated by the air. Okay, so the flowing fluid for hot fluid and cold fluid is same, that is air, is to be heated by the air leaving the system. Okay, so this cold fluid which is entering, the cold fluid which is air, which is entering the counter flow heat exchanger, is getting heated by the exit temperature of the hot fluid. Okay, it is getting heated by the air which is leaving the system, hot air which is leaving the system. That means if it is a counter flow heat exchanger and the hot air is hot, this is the hot air and this is the cold air. Okay, so the cold air is entering from this side having temperature of 280 Kelvin, that is given the question, and the hot air, this cold air is getting heated by the, this preheated air, this air which is coming out of the hot air or hot tube of the counter flow heat exchanger, and this temperature is 300 Kelvin. Okay, so this temperature is given to you 300 Kelvin, and this cold air is getting heated by this hot air which is coming out from the hot outlet side. Okay, so the both the fluid is air, and the mass fluid of hot fluid is 0.4 and cold fluid also 0.4. Okay, so the mass flow rate of hot fluid is equal to mass rate of cold fluid is equal to 0.4 in this question. Also, as both the fluid are air, so the Cp value will be same, as both the fluid are air, so both the fluid will be having same specific heat. So that means mass rate of product of hot fluid is equal to product of mass rate into specific heat of cold fluid. If these two values are same, so if you remember, my friends, I have told you in my video lecture of heat exchanger, if the value of specific heat, product of specific heat and mass flow rate are same for the parallel flow and for this counter flow heat exchanger, since this is a counter flow heat exchanger, okay, and the specific heat are same, so the value of LMTD will be equal to either delta TI or delta TE. Okay, so LMTD will be equal to delta TI or delta T. Okay, so you don't have to apply that LMTD formula, that is delta TI minus delta T or log of delta TI or delta T. You don't have to apply this formula for this particular case, since this is a counter flow heat exchanger and the value of product of specific heat into mass flow rate of hot fluid and cold fluid are equal. So the value of LMTD will be equal to either inlet difference in inlet temperature or difference outlet temperature. Okay, so since you knew this difference, so LMTD will be equal to 20 degree Celsius or 20 degree Kelvin. Okay, that is 300 Kelvin minus 200 Kelvin. Okay, so LMTD will be equal to 20 degree Kelvin. Now, in the question, you have to find the outlet temperature of the preheated air. How we are going to find the outlet temperature of the preheated air? For that, you have to find the value of heat transfer. Value of heat transfer will be equal to U, value of area is given, value of overall heat transfer coefficient is given. So you know that value of heat transfer is equal to UA LMTD. So value of U is equal to 20, value of area is equal to 20, and since you know value of LMTD is 20, so after solving it, this will equal to 8000 kilowatt. Okay, so the value of Q is equal to 8000 kilowatt. Alright. Now, since this heat transfer will be equal to, this will be same as heat transfer for the hot fluid. Okay, heat transfer will be same for hot fluid or cold fluid. That is MHCPH into THI minus THE will be equal to Q. So, this MHCPH value, you know this value, MH is equal to 0.4, CPH is equal to 1000 into THI minus THE. Now, this is 1000 joule per kg Kelvin. Always remember, this is joule per kg Kelvin and you got your value in kilowatt. So, either you have to convert it into kilo joule per kg Kelvin or you have to convert this into watt. Otherwise, you will get wrong answer. Okay. So, you have to convert this into kilo joule per kg Kelvin. So, this will be equal to Cp will be equal to 1 kilo joule per kg Kelvin. Okay. So, after putting this value here, this will be 8000 equal to 0.4 into 1 into THI. THI is equal to, THI is not given to you, so THI you have to find minus, actually you have to find the outlet temperature of the preheated air, and the outlet temperature of preheated air will be this air, TC, you have to find TC in this case. Okay, so this you have to apply MCCPC into TCE minus TCI. Okay, so you have to apply this formula here in this question. Okay, so this will be equal to TCE minus TCI. Okay, since the values are same, MHCPH is equal to MCCPC, so this will be equal to 0.4 into 1 TCE minus TCI. So this will be equal to 8000 is equal to 0.4 into 1 into TCE minus 280 Kelvin. Okay, so after solving it, you will get value of TCE equal to 300 Kelvin. Okay, this is your answer. That is option number B is your answer. And this is the outlet temperature of the preheated air. That is outlet temperature of the cold air. Okay. So, for this question, you have applied a very important concept that if it is a counter fluid exchanger and the value of mass weight of hot fluid and cold fluid product is same, then this LMTD will be equal to either delta TI or delta TE. Okay. Next question from Gate 116, set 2. In this question, it is given that there is a parallel flow heat exchanger with area AP. And there is also a counter flow heat exchanger with area AC. Okay. In both the heat exchangers, the hot stream is flowing at 1 kg per second, is getting cooled from 80 degrees Celsius to 50 degrees Celsius. And the cold stream in both the heat exchanger, the flow rate and the inlet temperature are given. Okay. That is 2 kg per second and 10 degrees Celsius. The hot and cold stream in both the heat exchanger are the same fluid. If it is given the question that hot fluid and cold fluid are of same fluid, that means CPH is equal to CPC. Same fluid means hot fluid and cold fluid are having the same value of specific heat. Okay. Also, both the heat exchanger have same overall heat transfer coefficient. That is U is also same for both hot fluid and cold fluid or for both parallel flow and counter flow heat exchanger. Okay. So, you have to find the area of ratio of counter flow heat exchanger area over parallel flow heat exchanger area. So, to solve this question, you have to draw a temperature profile for both parallel flow and counter flow heat exchanger. So, for the parallel flow, this will be like this. Okay. So, the inlet temperature, hot stream is flowing at 1, is getting cooled from 80 to 50. So, hot fluid is getting cooled from 80 to 50 and cold fluid enters at 10, outlet temperature is not known. Similarly, in this case, for counter flow, this is parallel flow heat exchanger and this is counter flow heat exchanger. Alright. This is given to you. This is unknown for counter flow. Okay. So, outlet temperature of cold fluid is unknown for both parallel flow and counter flow. Now, firstly, you should understand what you need to find. You need to find the ratio of area of the counter flow and area of the parallel flow heat exchanger. Now, how you are going to find it? You know that Q is equal to UA LMTD. Okay. Now, Q is the heat transfer. Okay. Now, this heat transfer for parallel flow heat exchanger will be this. And this formula will be same for counter flow heat exchanger. value of u is same for both parallel flow and counter flow. It is given the question, value of u is same. Also, value of LMTD, you need to find out value of LMTD, and value of area ratio you need to find out. So that means if u is same for both parallel flow and counter flow heat exchanger, so the formula will be equal to A into area of parallel flow heat exchanger into LMTD of parallel flow heat exchanger will be equal to LMTD area of counter flow into LMTD of counter flow heat exchanger. So area ratio of counter flow over parallel flow will be equal to LMTD of parallel flow over LMTD of counter flow. We can say that. So if we somehow find the value of LMTD for this parallel flow and LMTD of counter flow, we can easily get the area ratio. So how we are going to find the LMTD? So to find the value of LMTD, you need to find the outlet temperature for both parallel flow and for counter flow for the cold fluid. Okay. So how we are going to find the outlet temperature? We can find the outlet temperature by applying energy equation. For this parallel flow, we know that this is hot stream is flowing at 1 kg per second, cold fluid is flowing at 2 kg per second. But the value of specific heat for cold fluid and hot fluid is same. So we can say that 1 into 80 minus 50, where 1 is the mass rate of hot fluid, is equal to 2 into TCE minus 10. Okay. So after solving it, this will be equal to 30 is equal to 20 TCE minus 10. This will be equal to 15, TC will be equal to 25 degree Celsius. Okay, so value of TC is equal to 25 degree Celsius. And this value will be same for both parallel flow and counter flow. Okay, so this value will be same. Now, next thing is you have to find the value of LMTD. Now, LMTD value, formula is same for LMTD, that is, it is equal to delta TI minus delta TE over log of delta TI over delta T. Since this value delta TI and delta T are different for parallel flow and counter flow, you have to find the value of delta TI for this parallel flow. This will be equal to 70 and this will be equal to 25. For this value, this will be equal to 80 minus 25, this will be equal to 55 degrees Celsius and this will be equal to 40 degrees Celsius. Next thing is you have to put this value of delta TI and delta T in this equation for both parallel flow and counter flow, and you have to find the LMTD value for parallel flow and counter flow. For LMTD value of parallel flow will be equal to, you will get this value equal to 43.70, and LMTD value of counter flow will be equal to 47.10. Okay. So after solving it, you will get this value. Now next thing is that you have to put this value in this formula. Area of counter flow and parallel flow will be equal to LMTD of parallel flow over counter flow. LMTD of parallel flow is 43.70 and LMTD of counter flow is 47.10. Okay. So after solving it, this value will be equal to 0.927. Okay. So the area ratio of counter flow and parallel flow will be equal to 0.927. This was a very good question, but was kind of, you can say it was a very tough question also. Tough, why? Because it was very lengthy and you have to apply the concept of both parallel flow and counter flow in a one question. Okay, so this was a good question, alright. Next question is again from Gate 2016 Set 3. In this question it is given that for a heat exchanger, if delta T maximum is the maximum temperature and delta T minimum is the minimum temperature difference between the two fluids, LMTD is the log mean temperature, C minimum, C maximum is the minimum and maximum heat capacity rate, then the maximum possible heat transfer between the two fluid is. So I think this question was asked in 1 mark in GATE exam. This was very easy question. Why? Because if you remember the concept of heat effectiveness, I have told you effectiveness is equal to ratio of actual heat transfer over maximum heat transfer. And this maximum heat transfer was equal to MCP, small value. This MCP is nothing but heat capacity of small value. Small means minimum heat capacity value into product of THI minus TCI. Now tell me friends, if it is a कंपेलर फ्लो हीट एक्सचेंजर और इट इज अ काउंटर फ्लो हीट एक्सचेंजर, वैल्यू ऑफ डिफरेंस बिटवीन दिस टी एच आई एंड टी सी आई, दिस वैल्यू एंड दिस वैल्यू ऑलवेज, आदर इट इज अ पैरेलल फ्लो और काउंटर फ्लो, टी एच आई वैल्यू इट इज इनलेट टेम्परेचर हॉट फ्लूड वैल्यू विल बी मैक्सिमम टेम्परेचर एंड दिस वैल्यू विल बी मिनिमम टेम्परेचर एंड द डिफरेंस बिटवीन दिस मैक्सिमम एंड मिनिमम टेम्परेचर विल बी द मैक्सिमम टेम्परेचर डिफरेंस बिटवीन आदर हॉट फ्लूड और कोल्ड फ्लूड. ओके, सो दिस विल बी द मैक्सिमम टेम्परेचर डिफरेंस, सो दिस विल बी द मैक्सिमम टेम्परेचर डिफरेंस बिटवीन द हॉट फ्लूड एंड कोल्ड फ्लूड. ओके, सो इन दिस क्वेश्चन इट इज आस्किंग दैट व्हाट इज द मैक्सिमम हीट ट्रांसफर, मैक्सिमम हीट ट्रांसफर वैल्यू विल बी इक्वल टू पार्ट ऑफ मिनिमम हीट कैपेसिटी इनटू मैक्सिमम टेम्परेचर डिफरेंस बिटवीन हॉट फ्लूड एंड कोल्ड फ्लूड. सो आउट ऑफ दिस क्वेश्चन दिस ऑप्शन ऑप्शन बी विल बी द करेक्ट आंसर. ओके, सो दिस वॉज अ वेरी इजी क्वेश्चन बट क्वाइट अ यू नो कॉन्सेप्ट बेस्ड क्वेश्चन दैट वॉज आस्क्ड इन 1 मार्क्स. नाउ नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज फ्रॉम गेट 17 सेट 1. In this question, it is given that saturated steam enters at 100 degree Celsius, condenses on the outside of a tube. Okay. Now, cold fluid enters at 20 degree Celsius and exit at, this will be exit at 50 degree Celsius. The value of log mean temperature difference is need to be find out. Now, this question is special cases of LMTD. I have told you. It can be whenever a fluid is undergoing change of phase. Okay, so this is a case of condensation. Okay, so you have to draw for condensation for hot fluid, vapor is changing into liquid. Okay, so for condensation, phase change will be vapor to liquid. Now the hot fluid will remain in the same phase, that is, it will be in vapor phase. So this will be a constant line. For the cold fluid, now since in this question it is not mentioned whether it is a parallel flow or counter flow. So for all those questions in which it is not mentioned that it is a counter flow or parallel flow, you have to take it as parallel flow heat exchanger only. Okay. So if it is mentioned, it will be mentioned that it is a counter flow. If it is not mentioned, then you have to take it as a parallel flow heat exchanger. Okay. So the parallel flow heat exchanger, the cold fluid and hot fluid will enter from the same side. Okay, so inlet temperature of the cold fluid is 20 and outlet temperature is equal to 50 degrees Celsius. Okay, so this is a case of surface condenser, okay, in which vapor is changing into liquid. Okay, now this temperature THI will be equal to THE, which will be equal to 100. Now what you have to find, you have to find LMTD. LMTD will be equal to delta TI and delta TE difference over log of delta TI over delta TE. Okay. So delta TI will be equal to 80 degree Celsius and delta TA will equal to 100 minus 50, which will be equal to 50 degree Celsius. Okay. So LMTD will be equal to 80 minus 50 over log of 80 over 50. Okay. So after solving it, this value will be equal to 63.82 degree Celsius. Okay. So out of the given option, option C will be the correct answer. Okay. Now next question is again from 2017 set 2. In this question, it is given that it is a counter flow heat exchanger. So as I have told you in the previous question, if it will be a counter flow, they will provide you in the question itself that it is a counter flow. If it is not given, you have to take it as a parallel flow heat exchanger. Okay, so this always remember, friend, if it is not mentioned in the question that it is a parallel flow or counter flow, so by default you have to take it as a parallel flow heat exchanger only, and you have to solve the question by taking it as a parallel flow heat exchanger. Okay, now in this question it is a given it is a counter flow, you have to solve the question as a counter flow heat exchanger. Water is heated at rate of 1.5 kg per second from 40 to 80 degree Celsius, okay, by an oil which is entering at 120 degree Celsius and leaving at 60 degree Celsius. The specific heat of water and oil are given to you. The overall heat transfer is also given to you. What you need to find, you need to find the required heat transfer surface area in meter square. Okay, so solve this question. Again, I have told you, you have to draw the temperature profile first. Since this is a counter fluid exchanger, hot fluid will enter from this side. Okay, hot fluid inlet is 120. Okay, and exit is at 60 degrees Celsius. Cold fluid will enter from this side, this is 40 degrees Celsius, and outlet is equal to 80 degrees Celsius. Okay, need to find the required heat transfer area. So, you can find the area by using equation Q is equal to UA LMTD. So, solve this, find this value. You need to find this, need to get this value LMTD. You know the value of U is given in the question, which is 400 watt per meter square Kelvin. You also need to find the value of Q. Okay. So, firstly, we will find the value of LMTD. How we are going to find the value of LMTD? LMTD will be equal to delta TI minus delta TE over log of delta TI over delta TE. So, delta TI will be equal to 120 minus 80, which will be equal to 40 degrees Celsius, and delta T will be equal to, this will be equal to 20 degrees Celsius. Okay. So, LMTD will be equal to 40 minus 20 over log of 40 over 20. So, after solving it, this value will be equal to 28.85 degrees Celsius. So, LMTD will be 28.85 degrees Celsius. Next thing is that you have to find is, you have to find the value of heat transfer. Now, heat transfer will be equal to Q, will be equal to, since the flowing fluid in this question is given that there is a hot fluid which is water and cold fluid is oil. Hot fluid is oil and cold fluid is water. Okay. Now, Q will be equal to either MHCPH into THI minus THE or MCCPC TCE minus TCI. Okay. So, you can find either of these values, but you can see that in this question, the mass flow rate of only water is given to you, which is 1.5 kg per second. Mass flow rate of oil, that is hot fluid, is not given to you in this question. So, to find the value of heat transfer, you will be using this equation, because mass rate of oil, water is given, but mass rate of oil is not given. That is, hot fluid mass flow rate is not given. So, you can't apply this formula. You can use only this formula. Okay. So, heat transfer will be equal to 1.5 into CPC. CPC value is equal to 4.2 for water. This is 4.2 into TCE minus TCI. TCE minus TCI will be equal to 80 minus 40, which will be equal to 40. Okay, so the answer will come out to be 252 kilowatt. Now, this is 252 kilowatt. Okay. Now, in this question, as you can see that overall heat transfer coefficient is in watt per meter square Kelvin. So, you have to find the value of area. You need to convert this heat transfer, which is in kilowatt, into watt. So, this will be equal to 252. Okay. 252,000 is equal to U into area into LMTD, which is 28.85. Okay. So, after solving it, this value will come out to be 21.84 meter square. Okay. So, option D will be the answer. Okay. So, this was a very good question from GATE 2017. Now, next question is from GATE 2018 set 2. In this question, it is given that steam in the condenser of a thermal power plant is to be condensed at a temperature of 30 degrees Celsius. Okay. With cooling water which enters the tube of the condenser at 14 degrees Celsius and exit at 22 degrees Celsius. Okay. Overall heat transfer coefficient is given. Total surface area of the tube is also given. You need to find the net heat transfer in megawatt. Okay. You have to find the heat transfer in megawatt. Okay. So, how you are going to solve this question? You can solve this question by, firstly, this is a case of a condenser. Okay. So, you have to draw the temperature profile for a condenser. This will be the temperature profile. Now, since in this question it is not mentioned that it is a parallel flow or counter flow, you have to take it as a parallel flow heat exchanger. Okay. So, cold fluid will enter from the same side of hot fluid. Now, the inlet temperature of the hot fluid is given that steam it is to be condensed, which is having temperature of 30 degrees Celsius. Okay. So, the temperature of steam is 30 degrees Celsius, and the cold fluid, which is water, enters at 14 and leaves at 22. So this is cold fluid which is at 14 degrees Celsius and leaves at 22 degrees Celsius. Okay. Now you have, in this question it is given that area is given 50 meter square and overall heat transfer coefficient is 2000 watt per meter square Kelvin. What need to find? You need to find the value of Q. Q will be equal to UALMTD. Okay, so these two values are given to you. You need to find the value of LMTD. Now to find the value of LMTD, you need to, this value will be again equal to 30. So LMTD will be equal to 30 minus 14, that is delta TI, 16 degrees Celsius, and this will be equal to 8 degrees Celsius. Okay, so you have to find the value of LMTD. LMTD will be equal to delta TI minus delta TE over log of delta TI over delta TE. Okay. So after solving it, this LMTD will be equal to 11.54 degrees Celsius. Okay. So LMTD value is 11.54. You have to put this value in this equation. So the value of heat transfer will be equal to 2000. Remember, this is in watt per meter square Kelvin, okay, into 50 into LMTD, which is 11.54, okay. So after solving this question, the value will come out in watt, because this was in watt per meter square Kelvin, this is in meter square, this is in degree Celsius, so the value will come out to be in watt. You have to convert this value into kilowatt by dividing this value by 10 power 6. You have to find the value in megawatt, right? So you have to divide whatever value comes, this value will come out to be in watt, okay? So you have to find the value in megawatt, you have to divide this value by 10 power 6, okay? And the answer will be equal to 1.154 megawatt, okay? And this value can only find out by dividing the value of heat transfer, which will come out in watt. You have to divide it by 10 power 6, okay, then only you will get the value in megawatt, which is 1.154 megawatt, okay. So this was a very good question, and with this we conclude our PYSP, that is previous year GATE questions on heat exchanger. So I hope you have understood the concept, and the concept is very simple, that you have to either you have to remember all the formulas for heat exchanger and also the concept for those effectiveness and LMTD, okay, then only you will be able to solve the question. Remember, if it is not given the question, you have to take it as a parallel flow heat exchanger. If it is mentioned that it is a counter flow, you have to take it as a counter flow heat exchanger. Also, don't forget to draw the temperature profile first. If you are not able to draw the temperature profile, you won't be able to find the correct value of LMTD, okay. So draw the temperature profile. Firstly, see whether it is a counter flow or parallel flow. Then draw temperature profile, find the value of LMTD, and then you can solve the question. Okay. So I hope you have understood the concept. If you understood the concept, please like this video, comment on it if you have any doubt, and please subscribe to our new YouTube channel for GATE. This particular video is also given on our new YouTube channel for GATE, where you will get the latest video for related regarding our latest video and latest information regarding GATE 2019 preparation. And this particular video is launched on our new YouTube channel. Please subscribe to it. Please share it with your friends. And don't forget to like it. And don't forget to comment. If you have any comment or if you have any doubt, you can also comment on the video. Okay. So please like it and subscribe it. Okay. With this, I conclude my today's video lecture. Thank you and have a good day.